Let's discuss about some points related to different frequency ranges for sound waves. There are few facts we need to discuss about sound waves, like all sound sources may not oscillate simple harmonically. That means all sound waves need not be simple harmonic waves. So, we can state pulses of such sound by these sources may not be sinusoidal. So, we cannot directly apply the relations which we have studied about just simple harmonic waves for every sound wave. Another fact about human ears, we can write that normal human ears can hear all frequencies in the range between 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz, that is 20,000 hertz. This is the range which you might have studied in your early classes also. And as the age of human ear increases, the range decreases, and we can write in middle age, just for knowledge I am giving you the idea, that in middle age this range is approximately from 10 kilohertz to 15 kilohertz. It is up to this level it reduces. Very high frequencies in middle age or in old age human ears are not able to hear. We can also write that this 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz, this is called audible frequency range. And we can in parallel keep in mind that it decreases with age. And other than audible frequency range are two other ranges which are called infrasonic frequency range, which are frequencies less than 20 hertz. These are the frequencies which are less than 20 hertz, so these are not under audible frequency range, so it can't be heard by human ears. But we can say some animals may hear these frequencies. Similarly, we can define another frequency range which is called ultrasonic frequency range. This is the frequency range in which the sounds are having frequency more than 20 kilohertz falls. A frequency of a sound is more than 20 kilohertz is not audible to human ears, but again some animals may hear depending on their structure of their ear. Like for example, we can write bats use approximately 100 kilohertz frequency for navigation purpose. This is the frequency which bats are using generally, because their ears are sensitive up to the limit of 100 kilohertz, which human ears can't hear. Let us understand some standard terminology used for frequencies which are emitted by musical instruments. We can say that overall sound from a musical instrument consists of many different modes of vibrations, or more precisely we can say whenever a sound from a musical instrument is produced, then a musical instrument produces sound which is a mixture of several frequencies. That's why when we hear sound from musical instrument, many frequencies we listen simultaneously. Out of all these frequencies, we can say the lowest frequency is called fundamental frequency. In the mixture, the lowest frequency of vibration which is there in the sound produced by a musical instrument is called fundamental frequencies. And we can say other higher frequencies present in sound, these are called overtones. These are standard terminologies which are used for sound produced by various different kind of musical instruments. The minimum frequency which an instrument can produce is called fundamental frequency, and all other higher frequencies are called overtones. For overtones, a specific term is also became popular, which is termed as harmonics. Harmonics are basically those overtones which have frequencies in integral multiple of fundamental frequencies. These are called harmonics. So we can say harmonics are those frequencies of sound by musical instruments which are integral multiple of fundamental frequencies. So these are the standard terms we generally use for various different kind of devices which produces sound. Even in numerical application, these terms are used. So be careful about the standard terms.